Today in this episode on our podcast at Sky Perth Talk, we are going to be talking about one topic that's really important, which is drone photography and videography for real estate. Stay tuned, stay with us, and let's roll!
Let's go!
Fala galera! Bienvenidos!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a new Sky Perth Talk podcast. No, not podcast.
Episode. It's podcast.
It's podcast.
Yeah, podcast episode.
Where we are now? Where are we?
We are in Perth.
No, we are in Amazon, Apple Music.
Ah, yeah. We are streaming. That's amazing. We are streaming pretty much like Apple,
yeah.
Podcast, Spotify,
yeah.
Amazon Podcast,
yeah. YouTube.
And Google Podcast,
YouTube.
And YouTube.
And of course, if you follow us in Instagram, you're going to be aware.
And plus on our website, skyperth.com.
Skyperth.com. The only service provided drone company in Perth.
So, Franco, today we're going to be talking about a topic that I believe, especially you as well, that start your... How long have you been flying drones?
For 2019 I started.
2019.
Yeah.
And I do believe someone have already asked for you to... Can you take a photo for me from a property that I have?
Yeah, real estate photography is kind of our, you know, main entry in the drone world, right? It's like the first thing that maybe you can have like an income, or you can charge, put a price, maybe something
cheap. Should do for free.
Oh yeah, yeah, of course. But it's like a good entry level of income with a drone, right? What is your experience about that?
I think when I started to do like drone photography in 2016, for me was really important, was a really good market that I, what I did at the beginning was, I have to confess, I did like a lot of jobs for free because I didn't have like a portfolio. So that wasn't a way for me to sharpen my skills, learn a few things. And those things I hope we can show to you guys today and explain a little bit what we have done. But for me, it was really important to get these skills, to create my portfolio and start showcase what I could do to my clients.
Yeah. I think a few steps that we have to take today is, you know, we have so many stuff to bring this information and break down how to start offering those services. But one of the most important is which drone to choose, right? To do this kind of services.
When you talk about drones, it's more about what you can buy.
Yeah.
And especially because you are starting, I don't think there is a point for you to, for example, buy a Spire 2 to take pictures, right? So you could buy a small drone.
Like a Mavic Air or Mavic Pro
Mavic,
2.
Yeah, a Mavic Pro. A Mavic Mini.
Yeah.
And sometimes those drones, if you know how to take pictures, and I hope at the end of this episode, we can give to you something that you can pretty much like use on your photography. But the drone, it's just a tool for you to have this final result.
Yeah.
So it's more about how much you want to spend.
Yeah.
What is your budget?
Exactly.
Of course, for a normal photography, a ground photography, if you have a drone, you're gonna bring a different perspective.
Yeah.
And that definitely will be something attractive, especially when you show like a portfolio for our clients, that they can hire you to do something completely different. Tell me about what was your experience? Why people asked for you to take like photos?
The first jobs that you are looking for as well, because maybe it's a real estate company close to your house, and or maybe you know someone that works there or close to them, and I don't know, it's the terrain when you feel comfortable, I think, because it's you don't have the client next to you, or maybe it's something that you can potentially do whatever day, whichever day during the week, something that is maybe more flexible, and that's why it's so easy to do. To be honest, maybe it's not the best market where you can receive like a huge amount of money, but it's a really nice market to start with and get, as you say, build your portfolio, right? Is which is the most important thing that you can cover with these kind of jobs. Build my portfolio, start doing post-production jobs as well, so I can know my drone, how to edit the photos, how to edit the videos, know more about software. So it's a great, great place to start with, and then, you know, step up and maybe start offering a better service in real estate, or maybe start with other industries, right? What is other recommendation that you can see after, you know, I choose my drone, I am flying recreational, now I want to start with this business. What maybe the procedure that I have to check to start work with?
I think before the procedure is everything, you need to find a client.
Yeah.
Right. So it's more important for you how you're going to find someone that can at least allow you to take those pictures and go there and show them. And I think you got a really good point. You could use someone close to your home, mm-hmm. close to your suburb, and talk with them. Hey guys, I'm here. I can have like this kind of service. I have a drone. I can take pictures for you. And I think that's the way for you to start. And especially when you look for a photography, I believe you need to start to be smart about what time you can have like the best photos, mm-hmm. best results. And in our experience, you have seen the photos that we can take during the golden hours, mm-hmm. generally are the ones that our clients like most.
The better looking ones.
Because they're better looking. And they, when you show the results, when you do like the post editing, people love it, they like, and they want you to do more jobs. But on the flip side, it depends of the kind of client that you have, yeah. or the real estate or construction company. Yeah. Some companies, they don't want shadows.
Okay.
So if they don't want shadows, generally you need to shoot during the day.
Yeah.
So you just need to be in compliance, not compliance, but at least align with your client's needs.
That's right. Because then maybe they want something for inspection in this kind of, or they want to really see the surroundings or the asset that you are taking photos or video,
yeah.
right? It's depending on the client's needs.
Yeah.
But usually to do some more artistic jobs, mm-hmm. sunset or sunrise, maybe
they are the best ones. Yeah. And we can say for you, I think one of the recent photos that we shot is this one off the stadium.
Yeah.
We were there to shoot during sunset.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of real estate.
Exactly.
It looks like a real estate, yeah. because we are pretty much like taking a picture of a building,
yeah, exactly.
which in this case is the Opti Stadium, but you can see the lights, you yeah. can see like the sunset.
The depth of feeling that.
Exactly. And also you can see the city on the background,
yeah.
the colors are different, pops a little bit more. So, and the building have like all the lights, so it looks better.
Mm-hmm. What is the other recommendation that maybe, we talk about this, I think you are better than me, you can explain better than me, but we start like flying recreational, we choose the drone already,
yep.
we are finding the clients
yep.
to do this. Is some kind of regulation that we have to follow? Is some paperwork that we need to do?
Yeah, that's a good point. I think if you are doing this photography for the first time, it's really important to understand that not everyone loves drones.
Yeah.
On the contrary, some people, they think that you were there to spy them. You're there to take pictures of someone inside of the bathroom or whatever.
Yeah.
And they don't realize that sometimes with your phone, it's easier for me to have a zoom
exactly.
and take a photo from everyone. But if you want to do like a job, a real estate job, and you don't wanna, you wanna try to mitigate or at least avoid like angry neighbors, it's good for you to scout the area first, understand the location that you have to fly. Sometimes you need to understand to get a really good angle, you might need to fly close to another residence, another proper.
Yeah.
So it's good for those people to be aware that you are going to be doing that.
Yeah.
So take time, arrive early on the location,
mm-hmm.
go to the neighbors, ring the bell, or even write like a paper, have something, give to them, say, hey guys, I'm Rod from Sky Perth. I'm here to take photos of that property number one on this street A, right? And show to them that you're going to be there around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And if the drone is going to be close to them, they know already what's happening. They know that you're shooting like this property. So those are the things that you
need to be aware.
You need to be aware and avoid like, to fight or like
people have any issues with them.
Yeah. And when you don't do that, it's funny how things work, because people is going to come
and complain about it.
They're going to complain because it's a neighborhood, right? Yeah. And people going to, they don't know what's happening. They don't know why you're doing that. And sometimes you have to fly a little bit closer to their properties. Just let them know, right? And the other thing that's important is if you scout the area properly, you understand the location that you are, and some places you need to talk with the consul as well from their location, right?
Yeah.
So talk with the consul, see if there isn't any special permit that you need to have, or at least let them know that you are there. Like 99% of the time that when you do this, everything runs smoothly, nothing happened with you, people know, and even in some case you have like rangers, right? Because not everyone communicate with everyone, so when rangers come, you can talk with them. And the other thing that I taught, using my experience again, I always asked to the real estate agent or the company that hired me to write like a letter and explaining why and what I'm doing there, right? So explain to them, generally, if you have, and I think that would be good, we could create like this
kind of letter.
Template and give to people, because that was really hand for me in all the time that I was doing this kind of project.
Yeah.
I give this letter to the real estate agent, they just complete fill up the gaps, and I was able to use this and show to people, hey, that's what I'm doing, I'm not here to fly over your company.
But of course, again, something simple is we need to have license or all the permits to do these kind of jobs, right?
Yes and no.
Okay.
Yes and no, why? Casa, pretty much, if you are in Australia, I'm not 100% sure about other countries.
Yeah.
But here in Australia, CASA, that the organization that regulates all the laws, everything here, they gave special permission for everyone that has like a drone with less than 2 kilos. So you need to register your drone, but not necessarily you need to have like a license as a pilot.
Oh, okay.
So you can fly commercially
and
doing these kind of jobs, but if your drone is weight more than 2 kilos, you need to have the license, everything.
Something unusual for our Sky Perth talk is we have a new person in the team. Do you know that?
Oh yeah,
she has some questions.
She has some, and it's really good, because there are some people in our audience that they are asking some questions, and with you guys.
Our producer, Ana Conte Barbosa. She's laughing. Woo-hoo. What's happening?
Hello, guys. we received a question from the audience. So they ask, what camera settings should be used for real estate shooting?
That's a really nice question, right?
That's a really interesting question.
And again, let's talk about drones, because it depends which drone you have, because some drones, they don't have the same capabilities than the other ones. So, but one thing that maybe you need to make sure is to shoot with the highest resolution possible, talking about video first. If you can shoot the maximum resolution possible, like for example, 4K, if you can, with 50 frames per second, you have more.
Okay, Franco, can I stop you here now?
Yeah.
What we should be doing, right? Because you said the highest resolution.
Yeah.
What do you think if we create a new podcast that we can show to our audience how to edit a video and a photo?
That's going to be amazing.
I'm going to be doing that.
I'm going to watch that.
Cool. That's our promise. Next episode, we are going to be doing. So today we are going to show to you guys everything that you need to do for the photos and videos.
Yeah.
Next episode, how to edit.
Yeah, how to edit. How to edit the photos and the videos.
And the videos as well. Oh, boy. That'll be amazing.
Well, I think have a look also the settings for your camera. Uh-huh. Some drones, the most of the drone, they can shoot in RAW, which is maybe DNG in DJI drones, the format, but some of them, maybe the DJI minis, they still like having the JPEG format,
mm-hmm.
which is maybe you have maybe less play around in post-production, but it's still good. But you need to know your drone, have a look, watch tutorials in YouTube, and read the manual as well, which is really important to see how many sensors your drone has as well. So you can figure out if you need to turn off the sensor, if you are flying close to the building.
Yep.
And one of the most important thing for me, I think, talking about the settings of the drone is the smoothness of the gimbal, right? To get some smooth shots, like really slow shots.
When you talk about filming, right?
Exactly. Okay. I think the softness or the smoothness of the gimbal is one of the most important aspects to have a look.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you mentioned like RAW, and let's take in consideration that people that are watching this video not necessarily know everything about drones, right? So tell me, what's RAW? What RAW means, and what are the benefits for me to shoot in RAW?
The RAW image is the file that allows you to get a better post-production work. For example, in Lightroom, you can touch, I don't know, the shadows, the highlights, the exposure. It gives you more information inside of the photo, so you can play around, change a little bit the colors, push the a little bit more the colors so the image looks better. You have like more capabilities inside of the photo, and it's allow you to get better results at the end of the
process. What are you saying is you are going to explain for everyone how to use RAW photos to create the amazing photos that you do.
Exactly. With your help, we want to do that. We can do that together. Yeah, definitely, because you are the most experienced one.
Franco is a humble guy, but I think he's the one that edit a lot of photos, and the results are amazing.
Thank you so much. Yeah. You can see our photos in our stock footage section in our website.
That's true. Yeah, that's a good point. I was not prepared to say that.
We can do another podcast. You can do that.
But it's good. I think the results, everything that we've done, not only more about real estate, but also all the project that we've been working, and some footage and some photos that we've been taking, they are available on our website for you to purchase. We are not selling prints anymore. It's just like the file that you can download, and you can print by yourself, you can do everything, and you even use the files on documents, on anything that you need, like a really high quality image.
Yeah. So is any reason why you choose go 100% digital instead of offer maybe prints that maybe many people is doing nowadays?
I think print, it's something that everyone is doing.
Yeah.
And if you want, what's happening is you with the digital file, you can choose where you want to print, the way that you want to print.
You have more freedom and the size.
Exactly. And you not necessarily need to print that.
Yeah.
So sometimes you need to have like a banner for your website. You need to print like a annual report. So there's so many use for a digital file that you can use this instead of only print. Because before I was only printing, I only give this format to our clients. And all the time they are asking, oh, can I buy a digital file? Can I do this?
Can I change the size of the camera?
Exactly. So we didn't do that. But now is
it's easier.
We give this freedom to them.
That's really good. And also related with real estate, I remember a guy here in Perth that he wanted to sell his house, like, I don't know, 20 years ago. He explained me the process to sell his house. It was like a huge house, beautiful house. What he did was, I think he paid a photographer, a ground photographer, to do the photos. It was like 20 years ago. And he did like a photography book.
Uh-huh.
And he showed to the potential buyers this kind of book,
uh-huh,
with all the photos. And he sold his house because
of the book.
Yeah, because of the photography book.
So
yeah.
Basically, the way that the guy created this book was showcasing the house in a way that
exactly.
No one,
yeah, exactly,
could see before.
Exactly. So it's a really good niche with the drones nowadays to do something really quick, simple, with great result, because everyone that wants to sell or buy a house really appreciate those kind of drone shots, you know, because you can see the surroundings, what you have next to your house, potential house, the roof, you see the walls, see the, maybe the construction quality of the house. So yeah, I think it's a really right moment to start doing this.
So what are you saying, for example, if I have like an aerial photo,
yeah,
I would be able to see what's the supermarket close to this house?
Yeah.
What is the house? It is close to the beach.
Yeah.
It's close to the freeway.
Yeah, yeah.
Or...
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
that's true. Yeah, it's like you see sometimes in the description of the real estate that they say, yeah, the beach is really close to the house, and you saw the the photos and see that the beach is really far away.
Right.
So
that's really good, Franco. For example, when you have to take like a photo for real estate, do you need to have like a perspective that it's you are capable to show and point on the photo, like here is the supermarket, here is the freeway, here is the school, here is this, the beach. Is there something that you need to do as well?
Yeah, exactly. As a drone pilot, you need to become kind of professional photographer or read a little bit more about photography, so you can maybe play around with different kind of shots, not just the typical top-down shots or maybe really close-up. You need to play around and see, of course, having a look at your surroundings if you can, but have those wide shots of the property, medium shots, close-ups, top-down.
Mm-hmm.
So you have different perspective, and then the people or the person that ask you for those photos, they can choose, or maybe they can show a different perspective of the property and you know, and show better results or the potential clients can really appreciate the space that the property is.
I remember that you said something about every drone has their own settings. It's different. Not all the drones can shoot like raw.
Yeah.
You can correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe all the drones, you can have like at least the grid.
Yeah.
Why do you think the grid, when you see the photo, is important to create like a good composition?
Is maybe the most important aspect in photography, have a good composition, right? You have maybe the subject in the center, or maybe play around with the different weights, visual weights that you can find in the subjects or in the background. Don't leave too much space on top, like in the sky. Don't leave just a small sky as well. So like find like a medium term. It's all that stuff, I think we cover in our beginner photography guide for new pilots. So when I leave again in
so
the description.
What I'm saying, it's on our guide for
beginners. It's already done. You have to have a look and start shooting with your drone. Yes,
and
really nice.
How I can have access to this guide?
You need to go to our description here in the video and press the link, and you can download for free.
Fantastic.
Yes, really.
So
good.
It's there.
Yeah, it's everything there. But yeah, composition is one of the elements in this guide, one of the checkpoints that we need to pay attention as professionals as well, is like the fundamental. See, okay, I am a really nice drone pilot, but I am showcasing what the clients want. I am showing all the surroundings. I am showcasing really well the property, or I am showing something which is wrong, or I am showing more in one side than another one. I am showing too much sky. Mm-hmm. You need to pay attention. Also start working with maybe panoramic photography as well as you do. Yeah.
So panorama is really important.
Oh,
we have like something, and we have another question. Oh,
another question. What's happened?
Question, guys. Received just one. What are some common mistakes to avoid when taking drone photos for real estate? Oh. Or the most challenged situation you face when you shoot?
I think one of the common mistakes, especially because we are flying a drone, right? So the machine is pretty much like up in the air, and people don't realize that sometimes for photo, we have to have like the drone static. The drone needs to stop. Mm-hmm. So don't fly the drone and take the picture. Oh, don't fly the drone when you're trying to take a picture. So fly, frame the position, use the grid to have a really good composition of what we want. Stop the drone, press the button, have the photo. Because otherwise you're going to have like motion blur. The photo is not going to be focused. And the other thing that generally happens, never happened with me.
Don't believe you.
You always, it's a good tip that always press like a button, there's something on your drone you can focus.
Oh, okay.
So focus is really important.
But I have another button, the record, that you forget every time.
The record. That never happens with me. Never happens with me, but sometimes it's good to press record and then to film. If you want to film, press record.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's a good one.
I think those are the at least in my mind that I remember. The other mistake is check if you are going to shoot and film something, check batteries before you go.
Yeah.
Charge everything. Don't trust that your battery is charged, because especially if you use DJI drones, they have intelligent batteries.
Yeah.
And it depends how you set up the drone, the batteries discharge, and that could cause you to not have like full battery at the time that you are shooting. That can give you some problems, doesn't give you the whole time that you are expecting to have. The other thing that's really, really important, don't forget your memory card.
That's really good, important.
I know that these drones nowadays, they have like internal storage.
But it's not enough sometimes.
Sometimes not enough. It could be good for photos, but when you have to film.
Yeah.
So don't forget your memory card. So it's good to have like a checklist. So batteries, memory card,
propeller, and filters.
Any filter is really important. I would say it's more important for film than photos. Mm-hmm. It depends on the photos, of course, right?
Yeah.
Because if you're gonna take photos in, for example, have like ocean or water, generally the ND filters, the polarizer can give you a little bit of punch and gave you a little bit more of the blue and remove a little bit of the reflection. But when you are filming, and if you want to do something like have like this cinematic style and have like this beautiful motion blur, so you need to use the energy filter. I think that could be another good episode, because so you could talk about just about that. That would be amazing, because you can have like a proper time and explain this.
When to choose the right ND filter, or
there's some rules that you should be following, which is like, if you're gonna be filming 25 frames per second, you double up the shutter, so it'll be 50. So you know that it depends on your drone, and if you have a small drone, you don't control the aperture. That will be really bright.
Yeah.
So you need to have like an energy filter to pretty much like have like a, it's basically like works the same like a sunglasses. So you can see properly and you can shoot. And especially if you be during the day and if you be like sunset or sunrise, you need to see if it's needed, the energy filter is needed. What is more, and also you have like normal energy filter, you have polarized energy filter. You need to understand a little bit and why you have to use them.
That's good. Okay, I think I pretty much we covered everything, all the aspects.
Do we have...
Yeah, we have another question.
Yeah, we receive another question. Do you have any liability when you fly drones on real estate? Any request about it? If like we are getting a property that is private.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the liability about it? Like, do you need to provide any documentation to make sure you are covered?
Yeah. I think I don't know, Frank, maybe you can explain this a little bit better. But despite the fact that you fly on the Sky Perth now and you have covered about all the insurance, everything.
Mm-hmm.
But before, unless you work for a company that has like AROC, was really hard to have insurance. So it's really important sometimes, or it's really important for you to have insurance because things happen, right?
Yeah.
So you're flying a machine that maybe because of wind or something can blow your drone.
Smash with the wall.
It's smashing the wall, it's smashing the window, can broke something. And if you have insurance, you are covered about that. But a part of that as well, you have to be aware. I think we talked about this before, but you are flying over like properties. We are flying close to other places that could be, it's private properties, but belong to a council or everything.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to have like the permits to fly on this place. So you need to understand these and be liable about everything that you do.
Exactly. As we mentioned before, talk with the neighborhood, with all the people around, and see what is your plan for today, how many hours you wanna be there, if you need to come back, or if you wanna finish that day. And so everyone knows what is your procedures, as we mentioned, do the checklist, make sure that this inside of that checklist, like talk with the surrounding people as well. So it's pretty much that. Everyone needs to be aware so you don't have any complaints about your job. It's another one.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Not the word. Our audience is interacting.
Yeah,
a lot.
Okay, that's good.
It's good. So what post-processing techniques should I use for real estate drone spots?
Oh, I think that's the theme for us to talk about on the next podcast. Stay tuned, and we are going to be talking about that.
But we can mention roughly that we need to see the lines of the properties, see everything is straight, touch a little bit the colors, pump a little bit everything, so you know it kind of, you sell kind of the dream. So we have so many things to talk about that, and we're gonna do in the next episode, of Sky Perth Talk. But we have more questions.
Oh boy.
In case the real estate requests drone shots, but also ground photography or videography, do you think, like, what is the hint to provide to the person the best lighting, how he can manage this, like shooting for both ground and drone? And he needs some special equipment with photos, or what's the best equipment he can use, and that is not gonna be too expensive but good quality.
I think for photos, there are so many equipment and so many cameras that you can take and have nowadays. That's more about which camera do you have, understand your camera properly. There are so many settings that you can use, research properly. But the most important thing, if you are doing ground photography, is basically what you said about the lines. Remember that you are taking pictures, but you're trying to mimic your eye.
Mm-hmm.
And if you realize whatever you look, always the lines are straight. So, and pay attention on that. Remove like this distortion of the lines everything.
Yeah.
And a good practice, sometimes it depends of the kind of the photo you're taking, but if you're taking photos on golden hours,
yeah,
and it's always good to have like shoot the photos in brackets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do you remember what this technique?
Yeah, exactly. What I am remembering now, more than drone, what is the most, the issue that I see most in those kind of shots is inside of the house. The photographer does, they do kind of the beautiful shot inside, but all the windows are blown away, you know?
Blow away. Look. Because they don't use this technique, right?
Exactly. So you see the beautiful shot in a white house, the small, the really nice kitchen, everything, the walls, yeah, looks amazing, but the windows is white.
Yes.
You don't see the green of the, you know, the plants outside.
And nowadays we have like, we're gonna be teaching people to do that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But just to summarize this.
How is the technique?
Yeah. The technique is like to shoot in brackets is shoot one photo under exposure,
mm-hmm,
normal exposure, overexposure.
Yeah.
So you can use like Lightroom, mm-hmm, to pretty much like put those three images together.
Yeah.
So in that way, the tool is gonna grab the best of light of all those three images. And when they put all together, gives you this effect that they call HDR.
Yeah, exactly.
So you're gonna have like the best from everything, plus potentially like the outside pretty much like properly exposure everything.
Yeah.
But we have a different technique to do this as well, so maybe you can take like a one picture inside,
yeah,
or under exposure everything, just exposure outside,
yeah,
take these pictures, this picture, and after on Photoshop you can pretty much like
play around,
create masks. Frank's gonna teach you guys. Don't worry about it. He knows everything about Photoshop, like rooms.
But yeah,
eye design.
We pretty much cover everything, right? How to do your photography and videography for real estate with your drone. If you are new, if you are a beginner, those are some tips that we already did in our careers. It was really helpful for us. It's a really good niche to start with, mm-hmm, to start knowing more about your drone, to start, you know, giving the deliverables to the clients, play around with the color grading, post-production. Yes, I think it's a really nice industry.
I think we talk a lot. And Frank, do you have any examples that we can show of your shots?
Yeah,
from your stage?
Yeah, of course. Those examples are the ones that we are watching now. They are really, really specific for this kind of client because they are architecture. It's an architecture company,
mm-hmm,
and they does all these kind of buildings. They design as well, so the aesthetic for them is really, really important. So they wanted something really bright, really smooth shots. The color grading is pretty much natural. So yeah, the smoothness and the softness in the colors was like a really important requirement for these people. So yeah, it's as we say, not just real estate, but maybe you can work with architectures and you have so many options around,
yeah,
to start your portfolio.
I think at the time that you master all these real estate techniques,
yeah,
if you want to keep doing this kind of job, construction companies,
mm-hmm,
they are another level,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
They are above, I think I would say, from real estate.
Yeah.
And generally they know exactly what you need to do, exactly the camera that you need to have. They are really pick what you need to do.
Mm-hmm.
And they need someone that's really specialized on this. And I think that could be a potential client that you could pursue. But I believe, as you said, that we cover everything. Guys, if you need any questions, if you have anything that we didn't cover but you want us to talk, just comment below. We are going to be more than keen to answer your questions. Franco, you have anything to say to us today?
just thanked Anna to be participate today in the podcast. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. We hope you listen in the next one as well.
My pleasure.
Yeah, are you want to participate in the next one?
I can, yeah.
I can. But yeah, thank you as well to everyone that sent to us like the questions.
Yeah.
We really appreciate everything. We hope to serve everyone and see you next time.
Thank you so much, guys. This was SKY PERTH Talk. See you in the next one.
Ooh.
Bye.
I said to Anna, we should be changing this. We have to change this music for a sample or something.
Yeah, we should. We can start changing everything.
But I love the way that the people are asking questions for us. Hey, we have our podcast is really new and people are sending messages to us.
It's unbelievable.
Yes,
where did you find these amazing questions? Your friends or they are architectures?
No, it's
the friends that you were watching us and you mentioned that you're going to be doing this podcast.
Yeah, we just received by email.
Oh, cool.
Email,
yeah.
Wow. How old are they?
From our website.
Oh,
website.
They message us directly from the website.
Cool.
So easy process, just put your name, your email, put your question, any message.
Yeah, that's great. Let's do that.
Yeah.
And we see it from Instagram as well.
If you are a big company, yeah, hire our services. Put your company.
Yes. Okay, bye. See you guys. Woo! Woo! That was good. That was fucking good.